Second video about the topic of, how did I call it? Technological income displacement. Not technological job loss or technological employment, technological income displacement, because that's the problem here. Video 001, a short mind experiment. Bear with me because this is a very intricate thought I conjured up. Imagine the thought experiment that as a human, your consciousness resides in this little lump over here in your brain. Consciousness, awareness, sentience, self-awareness, give it a name. Maybe some part of your consciousness resides in your hormonal system or the feedback between your body and your brain. Or there is a feedback, according to my friend, with your intestinal flora, or it is highly influenced by your intestinal flora. But let's say that most of it conscious here and some algorithmic influence can be connected to the body. Now let's take an animal. Let's think of an animal that is somewhat comparable to a human, but different enough for us to allow us this experiment. Let's say we have a not a humanoid animal, so no monkeys, but let's say a quadrupedal animal, pig. Yeah, I think like a pig would be a good example. Let's take a dog because I'm very familiar with dogs. Let's assume a very big dog because there has to be some space. We can't take a chihuahua because there has to be space to take that brain. Literally, I use the metaphor as replacing the brain. Let's say we shrink down the brain or something, but we still have a brain in that format, and we place it in the context of a dog. So a really big dog, a dog of say weighing 100 kilos. A very big Eastern European Caucasian Shepherd, 100 kilos. We make space for the brain and we find ourselves functionally, and people will say this is impossible, but let's assume that it is somehow possible. So that we connect all the nerves meaningfully and there is a successful implant of a human brain in a sort of a dog substrate. What changes? What would you experience? We can do it very cinematic, like we are now compressed in a new form. Our hand doesn't have the full range of mobility and expression anymore, but that's a reduction in function. Well, now we're standing and I have like arm reach and I have leg reach and I have like speech. Those things are sharply reduced. So I'm now unable to express hand motion, probably more than a normal dog, because the feedback algorithms in my body would still allow me to do something with my hands. But since I don't have a frozen or thumb, grasping things would be very daunting and very challenging. So we would see an enormous amount of reduction of capacity. I would also presume that the neurology of the dog is not fully equipped to take all the signals of the human brain, because the human brain gives off a lot of signals. But on the other hand, the dog could run faster. Stamina-wise, my dog has extraordinary stamina, especially for sprinting short distances. There would be other benefits, of which the nose would be the most important one. One very traumatic reduction is, of course, the eyesight. Humans have a very, very broad range of color experiences, whereas dogs only, experience black and white with some reddish tints. So my eyesight reduction would be dramatic. But let's go a little further and implant eyes that mix the characteristics of a dog and a human. So I wouldn't be too traumatized. My hearing would be dramatically better. My smell would be dramatically better. My speech would be all but amputated. I have a dog. I don't see my dog being able to express with that guttural vocal cords anything approximating human speed. It might be recognizable with some care, like sort of like a, just imagine it. Imagine the trauma of that sudden transformation. Imagine the how difficult it would be. There's a good movie about it called Brainstorm, where the chief character, Christopher Walken, best actor in the world, one of the best actors in the world, gets fed neurological or sensory data from a monkey, and he's visibly distressed over that experience. The recording helmet is placed over the head, and then placed the signal is fed from a monkey to a to the actor, to the character in the movie, and it's clearly an unpleasant experience for what you see. That transition, having some minor benefits like smell and hearing and running, but a loss of affordances will be traumatic. The functioning of the human, of the animal, the new animal will be severely disrupted. I think we can compare that to the transition we would see when artificial intelligence emerges. People grossly underestimate the idea of artificial intelligence emerging and the effect of artificial intelligence, the specific emergence of high-grade artificial intelligence, hyper-specialized, but in specifically artificial general intelligence. I cannot emphasize how disruptive and traumatic this would be. Economies right now function because of accountability and motivation and a manageable despair, manageable protest and revolt and anger. So if people get too angry, economy adjusts, political systems adjust in tandem. But I don't see anything like the same function after the transition through an artificial general intelligence driven economy. There is no way that this what happens afterwards is comparable to what happens before. I will explain this. I will go into more depth into this idea in the same in the next video. But let me emphasize it. Complete disruption of the existing system, massive loss of the old benefits, and some minor benefits that we cannot envision beforehand. So, what will this do? We don't know, but what we do know is that it will be, what we can conclude after some thinking, is that it will disrupt everything and might even collapse to the point of that we have to think of something new which has never been thought of before. So the dog human, the dog with a human brain would be equivalent to being severely physically disabled and would need major prosthetic interventions, or life, the infrastructure of life would have to radically change to make life in any way meaningful for the animal, for the created creature. Let's think about this for a few seconds and let me come up with some conclusions that emerged over the last 10, 15, 20 years.